The so-called pseudo-Clementine literature is apocryphal material that circulated under the name of Saint Clement of Rome, probably starting at the end of the 2nd century. Jung quotes the homilies of pseudo-Clement because they picture a deity not yet split into irreconcilable opposites of good and evil. As Christian doctrine underwent further development, the split became greater. But it had not yet happened in pseudo-Clement. Here, we can see the paradoxical Yahwistic God image, which described a God image incorporating good and evil as the right and left hands of God. A few of Jung's examples, an accumulation from various Jewish sources belonging to the first 2 or 3 centuries AD, referring to the occasion of the Exodus, says, "Once permission has been granted to the destroyer, he does not distinguish between the righteous and the wicked. Indeed, he even begins with the righteous." This refers to the avenging angel that executed the Egyptian firstborn. The destroyer does not distinguish between the righteous and the wicked. Indeed, he even begins with the righteous. Another text says that you should hide yourself at the moment of Yahweh's wrath. Because we are warned by him that at the moment of his uncontrollable anger, if a curse is uttered, it will indeed be effective. In other words, you had better be very careful what you say and what is said to you at the particular moment when God's wrath is kindled. Another text says, God's left hand dashes to pieces, his right hand is glorious to save. These quotations illustrate forcefully just what is meant by the paradoxical Yahwistic God image, and these images have direct psychological application. For instance, the remark that a curse uttered at the moment of divine wrath will be effective would refer to the psychological fact that if there has been a serious offense committed such that the Yahweh level of the psyche is activated, what takes place at that moment has extraordinary power and consequences. The statement that the destroyer does not distinguish between the righteous and the wicked corresponds to the psychological fact that the wrath of the self is an unconscious phenomenon. It is a force of nature. A tornado does not distinguish between the righteous and the wicked. It might even hit the righteous first. The same applies to the activated self. The figure shows Jung's theme of the self as a quaternion of opposites. The two different cross pairs of opposites are specifically related to the image of Christ. The left figure describes the Christ of Christian dogma, and the right one involves the opposites of good and evil, represented by Christ and Satan. The first relates to the Christ image as a union of God and man, having both human and divine, and both eternal and historical aspects. According to the doctrine, Christ was a pre-existent entity. He existed prior to creation on the one hand, and on the other hand, he was born into space and time, into an historical setting, and was therefore a specific historical being. Jung pictures that state of affairs, a figure that has an historical individual existence and yet is also eternal, and that is unique while being universal. His universality is represented symbolically as his being an inner figure that is contained in all humanity. He is the vine, you are the branches. Jung then spells out a second quaternity. This quaternity would apply if one considers that Christ and Satan together make up a whole. In that case, good and evil constitute one polarity. Spiritual and material constitute the other polarity, because Christ is a spirit but also becomes embodied by incarnation, and so he unites that pair of opposites.